our Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning, my dear friends in Christ. We begin this Sunday reflection in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, the church celebrates the Feast of Divine Mercy Sunday. And we give God the glory for witnessing this year, 2021, Divine Mercy Sunday. Thank you, Jesus. Our reading is from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, from verse 19 to 31. And our topic is directly from the mouth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He says, "Peace be with you. Peace be with you." It is not a coincidence that today we are celebrating Divine Mercy Sunday. And the Lord is telling us, on this same day, peace be with you. May that peace remain with us now and forevermore through Christ our Lord. Amen. These are some of the words of our Lord Jesus Christ to his disciples after his resurrection. Peace be with you. The events of the crucifixion and resurrection of our Lord must have caused a lot of confusion and anxiety in the hearts of many people at that time. Even the Roman authorities were confused as to how to explain to the people that Christ truly rose from the dead. Though the disciples were excited at the news of the resurrection, they were also confused and afraid of the reaction of the people. They were also very, very confused. So they were locking themselves up in rooms. Peace is very important, but remains a scarce commodity in our lives and in the world today. Peace is a scarce commodity. There is no doubt about that. It is also very important in our passage of about 12 verses, the Master said, "Peace be with you." He said it 3 times. There is trouble everywhere, in families, in communities, different countries, and the entire world. Nigeria seems to be having more than a fair share of these troubles, with the issue of banditry, kidnapping, and Boko Haram. Families are going through a lot of stress. In the midst of all these troubles, Jesus appeared and said, "Peace be with you." There is no man, no institution, or government that can truly guarantee peace. Your wife or your husband or your children cannot give you lasting peace. Your job or the government also cannot do much. People are searching for peace in different places. There are courses and centers of peace studies in our universities. Yet, we are far from having peace. Even in those institutions that teach about peace, they can also not give peace. With the money in your account, no one can buy peace. With that money in your bank account, hear me very well. You cannot buy peace. You cannot get peace in any shopping mall. Not at all. The only source of peace, true peace, that can endure is our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is the only source of peace that we need. He can create peace in our environment. Even if there is turbulence in our environment, He alone can give peace in our hearts. He can choose to calm the storm to give us calmness in the midst of storm, because He is the Prince of Peace. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace. And I want to ask you, child of God, are you troubled? Are you worried about anything? Are you searching for peace for your soul? Are you searching for peace in your family? Are you searching for peace in your community or in your country? Jesus Christ promises. He offers us His peace. Not as the world gives it. His peace is everlasting and not subject to conditions around us. We pray that all of us will embrace peace, the peace of God, and we shall also share the peace of God around us through Christ our Lord. Amen. I pray for those that doesn't have peace in their marriage, may peace reign in your home. May peace reign in your family. May peace reign in your heart. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Like I said before, no matter who you are, no matter the money in your account, if you don't have Jesus, you cannot have peace. Embrace God today and you will enjoy peace. Embrace God today and you will enjoy the peace that you cannot buy anywhere. I pray that today that we are celebrating Divine Mercy Sunday, the Lord will have mercy on all of us. The Lord will have mercy on those who seek Him, who look for Him, who search Him. In that darkness, in that storm, in that situation, may you receive peace now in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Happy Feast of Divine Mercy. And may the Lord bless you through Christ our Lord. Amen and amen. Enjoy your Sunday and have a fruitful week ahead. You are highly blessed. Amen. God bless you.